Now, the South African National Space Agency's facility in Hermanus is the Space Weather Regional Warning Center for Africa. Changes in space weather can negatively impact numerous sectors, leading to a cascade of operational failures. The facility monitors the sun and its activity to provide information, early warnings and forecasts, which are crucial for protecting satellites and the continent's national power grids. Our reporter Vanessa Poonah has more on this. Vanessa, thanks very much indeed for joining us. What is fascinating about this centre?
Peter, yes, good afternoon to you. And fascinating is indeed the correct word you used just now. We as the media were taken on a tour of the South African National Space Agency here in Hermanus in the Western Cape. And of course, we were shown a range of various instruments used in the fields of electromagnetics. And also at the moment, we are standing in what is known as the Space Weather Regional Warning Center for Africa. And of course, on the boards behind me, Peter, we'll speak a bit in depth about that just now. Of course, this is where the sun is monitored so that we here on Earth can have early warning systems to protect, for example, the aviation industries, but also things like using our cell phones, things like everyday events could have a huge problems if, for example, a solar flare happens, and there could then, of course, be an impact on those technologies. But joining me to speak about the work of the centre is a space practitioner, space weather practitioner, Mpo Chisapungu. Mpo, very warm good afternoon to you. First and foremostly, I think most people know what weather is. It's cold, it's raining. What exactly is space weather?
Thank you very much. Space weather is the weather in space. So the driver of space weather is actually the sun. And then why it's different from terrestrial weather is because we are looking at the different altitude in space. We start looking at the altitude of about 80 kilometers above the ground. And that's where most of these energetic particles from the sun, they get absorbed. And then the signals that we use, they get absorbed into that layer, which we call the ionosphere. So that's where we start looking at space weather.
Now, behind me, I see a number of screens here. Can you just tell us very briefly what exactly we are looking at the moment? that looks like the sun behind us right now.
Yes, it is the sun with the active regions, the bright areas on the sun that you can see. And on those bright areas on the sun, that's where solar flares happen, like an explosion on the sun. So the sudden brightening, which is happening on those active regions. And then with that, you also observe the material coming off from the sun, which we call the coronal mass ejection. And that material coming off is the one which can impact Earth and for a longer period of time. So
for the average person, the average South African, why is this important? I know that the aviation industry is dependent on the information that you will collate here and monitor in the centre. What impact will it have on somebody sitting at home watching TV, for example?
The signals that we are receiving, for example, for your DSTV, you receive them from satellites. And the satellite signal is coming from the satellite to the ground. So there is if we have a space weather event, those signals can get absorbed. So it can impact on those signals, and then you find yourself losing the signal for TV, for example, as well as for your navigation, your GPS. If you want to navigate, you have your cell phone, you don't know where you are going, you depend on your GPS on your cell phone, but that GPS on your cell phone which you are using, you are actually receiving the signal which is coming from the satellite in space. And if space, if there is storm, space weather storm in space, then those signals can get absorbed and then you lose your direction, for example.
So the South African National Space Agency just recently, I think late last year, was named by the International Civil Aviation Organization as the regional center. What does this mean, that we are the only center of this kind providing this kind of data monitoring for the African continent?
We have been selected as the regional warning centers together with the There are three global centers and two regional centers, which this one is one of the two regional centers. What it means is that we will be in the next 3 years, in 2022, we will start providing the space weather information to the aviation industry, which we need to provide them with the information or space weather information that will have impact on their HF communication, the satellite communication, the GNSS surveillance and applications, as well as the radiation impact. So we need to provide them with the information that can impact four of those areas.
Mpo, as a practitioner, a space weather practitioner, what exactly do you do on a daily basis? I see quite a number of graphs. Just briefly explain to me what it is that you do as a practitioner here in the center.
What I do is to monitor what's happening on the sun, and then we do analyze the data which is on the sun, and then prepare a space weather bulletin report that we send out to our clients to inform them if the space weather conditions are either quiet conditions or they are unsettled or disturbed conditions, so that they know that today is not going to be very quiet or it's going to be very quiet.
Thank you very much, Mpo Chisapungu, there, of course, a space weather practitioner, explaining to us exactly what she does here at this Space Weather Research Center. And also then, Peter, telling us that not only do we experience storms on Earth, but also solar storms happen with the sun, of course, and all its power. And, of course, people like Mpo keeping a close watch on what happens in the sun so that we on Earth here can be prepared to deal with any impact.
All right, Vanessa, we're going to leave it there, and I'm just waiting for someone to beam you up into space. Thanks, Vanessa. So, reporter Vanessa Poonah there at the Space Center there in the Western Cape.